Hello everyone, let's talk about counterweight. What is counterweight and why I wanna talk about it? Please take a look at the photos for you to understand why I am so interested in this device, in this thing. One can call it counterweight, one can call it a rise and fall pendulum, but it's too complicated. It's not simply pendulum, it's for old illumination, antique illumination. I bought this device in St. Petersburg and it costed me pretty much money, but it doesn't matter. Why I'm so interested? Because it's not simply counterweight. It's magnetic, definitely, and I'm gonna show you why I am so interested. Let's try to take a look what is inside. As you see, shape is like egg shape. We can see some kind of bolt inside. I mean, we can rotate. It consists of two sides. So it's not only counterweight. It's too complicated shape for only weight. Let's try to analyze and see what we are dealing with. Have you seen the light? First question. Why this counterweight is needed? There are a lot of information that 200 years or 100 years some counterweights fall down in very old palaces. And in, for example, Paris Opera, counterweights could weigh couple tons. If it's outside, we understand why we need counterweight, but it was really inside building, in huge buildings, and definitely not for candles. And plus, it's extra weight for normal, metal construction. Ceilings cannot carry too much weight. And why extra weight must be applied to normal lamps? Let's take a look. Weight about 5 kilos, 4.95 kilograms. But it's green, it's not yellow. Corrosion looks green, it means some copper inside. Sometimes we can scratch it and we see it's yellow and green. So it's made of conducting material like bronze and kind of steel. Inside we see this figure 13 and strange shape. I cut it for chemical analysis a little bit, but it looks like normal steel. Why normal counterweight can be so complicated? It's too complicated, it's too sophisticated for a normal counterweight. It's not just something heavy like stone. And why this figure 13? Let's take a look. Let's try to research. I took a sample for chemical analysis and we will continue our research a bit later in second part of the video. But now, let's take a look. Let's take a look at other devices like this. Why we need those holes in it? Some of them made of kind of ceramic stuff, but for the same purpose. So it's not necessary to be metallic. So why we need it? Why one needed this device everywhere? Because it's definitely not just for counterweight to rise and fall these candles. I don't think it's for candles. Why I think so? I will explain. Of course, I'm not the first one who is trying to research this issue and trying to understand how lamps were working 200 years ago, 100 years ago, antique lamps. It's definitely not for candles, because no way you can put candles on ceilings on 3, 5 or 6 meters in old palaces and abandoned mansions and so on. We can see it everywhere in old photos. Some kind of device and something like counterweight on beneath it. And it looks like we needed this counterweight to turn something on. To turn lamps on. Because these lamps were fixed to the ceilings. There is no way you can pull it down or rise up. This rise and fall counterweights, it was not for servicing lamps. It was needed to start, to ignite, to turn it on. Because it was not for kerosene or gas or something. It was not like here for wires. We could see no wires in the past. And what we see here, it's a kind of brochure, kind of letter, article about, it's kind of advertisement for lamps, antique lamps. And what we see here, we see kind of device with some places for lamps, for some lighting devices. And we see this counterweight, rise and fall counterweight with pulley or without it. And we see it here. I marked it for you. It was everywhere. It was separate device moving up and down to turn everything on and off. I'm gonna give you link in description where you can read article. It's in Russian with all explanation and description how it worked. But it worked like this, simply like this. We had this counterweight. It was pulled up to turn it on, to turn all lamps on. And we see holes inside these counterweights everywhere. It has the same design everywhere. It has the same shape like egg. And I made decision that it was used to hold something. I mean, it was kind of reservoir, some kind of water balloon or something, cylinder to hold something, something liquid. But what it could be, possibly? Water? No way. It's useless. It was something to interact with some kind of field of the lamps and to start them, to turn them on. What hypothetically, possibly, could it be? Let's try to think about it. And the only explanation could be like something that was used for free energy. And we definitely know that the only free energy liquid was mercury. It was mercury inside. Actually, not only mercury, but probably amalgam. Mercury amalgam with zinc. Zinc, we call it zinc. And maybe tin with mercury. Actually, it was a mix of zinc and tin with mercury. Why I think so? Because we definitely know that the name of it, this amalgam, is tain. Tain in French, in English, looks the same and sounds the same, like in Russian. In Russian, tain, taina, is a kind of secret, because now it's secret. But we see resonators, we see it's everywhere in old antique lamps. And those antique lamps were not designed for wires. And it was not designed for candles. It was for the same lamps, but working without wires. Free energy lamps. And we see those counterweights, let's call it like this, everywhere, many places. And many places and thousands of them. And we definitely know that old palaces had no smoke on ceilings and so on. So there is the only way to be illuminated and lighted using some kind of free energy device. And we know this counterweight was part of these free energy lamps inside, because we had different construction, different design of free energy lamps outside. But inside buildings we see devices like this. I have seen many of them, I have explored many of them. None of them were for wires and actually for acted as counterweight. As we could see, some of them working now like counterweight. Its design is too strange. only for weight. Yes, we need counterweight for some cases like this, but it's too complicated design, too sophisticated. We see some wires, but the wires were, it's kind of adopted design for later. That's how it we see it today. But 200 years ago, it acted absolutely different way. Look, I bought one of them, and I'm gonna show you what was inside. It's not only for weight. Actually, it's absolutely not for weight. And it has some strange shape and gap between the hull, the body, and this shape, egg-shaped ball, steel ball. I didn't know about this guy who researched this issue when I was making this video, but there is a gap, as you see here. We can put this cap on it. And this another cap, and we see another hole. Now I'm gonna screw it and fix it. And we need another hole for what? For nothing. And it's definitely metallic, but it's made of different metals. What inside and outside the cover? Cover was kind of bronze. Why it's bronze? If you have any ideas, please write in comments. What do you think about? Is it really simple counterweight, rise and fall counterweight with pulley, or it's really kind of shape to hold something inside? I just assume, just my idea. I think that it was mercury, because only mercury can attract free energy. Definitely it can improve antennas. Mercury can improve actually everything. It was used in thousands of devices in 20th century. And now mercury is prohibited. It's banned. They are about to ban it completely next year. So if you have any chance to buy mercury, buy it for the future. And just analyze the shape of this device. What do you think about it? If you have any idea, please write in comments. Chemical analysis didn't give me anything, but I will tell you later about analysis of this thing. It's normal, actually normal stuff, normal metals, nothing special. So I think that mercury was in between the body and this egg, steel egg inside. If you have any ideas how did it work, please write in comments, because I really need your feedback. And thank you for today, thank you for listening to me, and see you in next videos. Sorry for delays, I've traveled a lot, but I will give you more videos a bit later. Thank you, bye.